What's up, baby?
All right, Dalton. At the golf tournament.
Plans today, shoot under 66.
By yourself?
One of my best scores ever was a 64, and I'm trying to...
I shot a 67
on a par 3, Arnie?
Par 7.
Are you really filming people?
64 on a par 3?
Last night, these 2 ounces of maroon's all right. The other ones are scary. And this way, on no way,
what's up, camera?
He's got no time for you. Look at our brother, now he didn't want you to. So step out the queue, he makes examples of you. And there's no way you can say behind the golf.
About 5:40 right now in the morning, and it's the first day of fall running. Really, really excited about it. Blue team's about to dominate. That's all I got for you.
Oh my gosh.
What's a positive about fall running? What's a negative?
Negative is everything about it. Positive is nothing about it.
It's about 7:53 here on the UTSA campus. We're here at Pro Runner Cafe, gourmet food, hosted to the conditioning team fellowship breakfast. As you can see, we dominate the calf because we're starving. And just trying to get some of our energy back to where it was before we just ran our guts out.
Hey guys, it's Matt James here with Coach Casey Seltzer. We're here in the University Center Ballroom at a drug awareness, alcohol awareness meeting. We've got some acorns with us, as you can see there. We're going to drop bombs into the abyss. We've got softball on the left.
We've got a lot of targets. A lot of targets.
Basketball's up in front of them and tennis.
We got wild dogs with the football.
Not afraid to dome rock wild.
Let's see what happens.
All right, you missed.
We're gonna take a break.
Yeah, we gotta come back
to react. She's up the
side. I don't care if you saw me. The camera's on you, girl. You got nailed.
Love is a burning thing. And it makes a fiery ring. Bound by wild desire, I fell into a ring of fire. I fell into a burning ring of fire.
What's up, Jake? What, I have a question for you. Do you fake bake tan?
It's not fake baking. It's called getting a nice bronze, you know? I like to go and be a little darker.
Is it natural or fake?
It's UV radiation, so really it's still a real tan. It's just in a bed.
So you
put, get it outdoors?
So you put, like, the tanning lotion on, lay down there in the bed?
Yes, I do put the tanning lotion on.
Are you naked when you lay in that bed?
I am naked when I lay in the bed.
So you really don't have any tan lines, do you?
I do not have a tan line. It's pretty bronze.
So is that for your girlfriend or for yourself?
No, I do it for myself.
What about
really good?
The guys in the locker room who, like, really get grossed out whenever they hear about you tanning?
I mean, it really doesn't bother me. If they've got a problem with me being tan, it's probably because they're actually attracted to me because I'm so good looking. So if that is what is the case, they just need to turn and look the other way.
No shot!
What do you think of guys who fake fake tan?
It really doesn't bother me that much.
Doesn't bother you at all? Okay,
yeah.
Cool. Okay, so, what do you think?
It bothers me. I think it's gross, and they should just tan, like, outside, lay outside by the pool or something.
So it's okay if they tan by the pool?
Yeah, just not fake big. That's just too much for a guy.
Is that weird? So do you think if a guy has no tan line, it's a strange thing?
No.
No? Okay. If you had a preference, would you rather tan in a tanning bed, or would you tan outside?
Oh, definitely outside. Definitely outside. You can get by the pool, or BP with your shirt off.
You admit that it's either way.
Do you have a phobia of tan lines?
I don't have a phobia of tan lines. I just like an all-over tan.
If your boyfriend tanned, would you have a problem with that?
Not really, no.
If he joined you, like, if y'all went together and, like, tanned in separate beds together, like, hanging out, would that be weird?
Yeah, that's kind of weird. Okay.
What's your response to tan has homosexual tendencies?
That's false. Many people are bronzed and they're not gay.
Can we just clarify?
I'm extremely comfortable with my sexuality. That's why it doesn't bother me to go to a tanning
bed. Okay, can we just clarify what state you're from in this?
I'm from Indiana. I'm from the Midwest.
So you're it's
right there.
It is.
So you're not from Texas.
I'm not from Texas.
Okay, thank you very much. Down. Ryan Dalton, how you doing today?
Good. Just finished a short run with the baseball team, now sitting at Cat.
That's good. Hey, I heard about you recently doing some tanning in a tanning bed. Is that true?
Recently would be an understatement. I did it last year with my teammate Jake Wood. And
when's the last time you tanned?
Yesterday. Went to a session and in the booth. It was good.
Well, I heard the news that Ryan Dalton likes to use a tanning bed. I think using a tanning bed takes away from your manhood, takes away from any strength that he might have had previously, was sucked out of his muscles when he was in a tanning bed. I mean, clearly he's growing longer hair, it's getting blonde and wavy, and he's just turning into a female, I think.
Do you think the female race values a man with a tan?
They don't frown upon it. I think they would take a more tan fellow than a really off-white fellow, such as, yourself.
What do you think? Fake tan, yes or no?
I mean, it doesn't bother me.
Doesn't bother you? Okay. So if a guy's more tan than you are...
That would bother me.
That would bother you?
Tan guys are more attractive than white guys.
Okay. All right. That's good to know. All right. Thank you very much. So do you tan for the ladies or for yourself?
Half and half. Self-esteem makes me look good.
Where do you go to tan?
I have one in my apartment complex. I have one.
Okay, cool. And what tan lotion do you use?
None.
No tan lotion. Do you wear the small little glasses too?
No, I don't.
Just close your eyes?
Close my eyes.
I think it's pretty gay. Well, I say gay, but I've done it once, so I can't say it's completely gay.
You feel like you are just as masculine as before you tanned? You sure? Even more? What do you think about guys on our team tanning?
Tanning? It's very, very feminine. Very feminine.
How feminine would you say it is?
On a scale of 1 to 10, extremely feminine.
Okay, gotcha. As a non-tanner, would you say that we are the majority of the non-fake bakers?
Yes. I would say we have more solid ghost white butts than bronze butts in our locker room. I prefer being myself, getting the natural rays the right way. You know, you go out to the pool, you know, hang out naturally. You're not jumping in some bed with a bunch of light bulbs.
I know, with no clothes on. Isn't that weird?
No clothes on, just the brownness.
Thanks, all.
Outside.
As you can tell, Locus' locker is covered with a bunch of junk, chairs, trash cans, bats, buckets, cleats.
Locus, what was your reaction to your locker?
I thought it was a pretty bush move by two guys that will be getting some retaliation back. It's war.
It's
and
war?
I can see it going down bad for them.
Welcome to my dorm. No cribs will be complete without the tour of the fridge up here in the fridge. Sometimes saying ayo, gotta let go. I wanna celebrate.
you once, now I told you twice. We gon' light it up like it's dynamite. I came to move, move, move.